And Chris, you know, Tybee Island, I'm seeing Tybee South sensor. The highest wind speeds we got there were in the upper 20s, I think, in gusts from our mezzanette. But, you know, the rainfall amount, we're talking about 3 or 4 inches in that area near Hardeeville. Now, Hardeeville is a known spot on I-95 to flood over. And they actually got shut down. That happened a couple times back with tropical systems moving ashore. But that, you know, 7.04, James, got pulled up here. 7.04 inches in that area. You know, luckily that wasn't a little further north, or else I-95 would have been shut down. Looks like it did bleed over into that area.
And I didn't, get the biggest one, apparently, Shay, because there's a spot where it's over 8 estimated by the radar here.
Wow.
Chris, does that, because this is just south of Hardeeville, so this is kind of south of where you are, Chris. So I'm not sure, you know, what kind of verification we're going to see out of these numbers, but
I'm right there with you on that. You know, I don't know what the verification is going to be, you know, whether it's Kokoros or, you know, some kind of station there, you know, on the south side of 95, you know, outside of Hardeeville. But, man, the rainfall there, the video that you guys are showing, you know, that was shot over an hour after it happened. I mean, we were coming through the first time. I think the Weather Channel had our stream up. And, man, I'm telling you, being from the south my whole life, you know, you see these, you know, heavy thunderstorms, even tropical weather brings, you know, heavy rain. That rain was something else. I mean, that rain was unbelievable. And I would not be shocked if there was 7 or 8 inches that fell in there, because there's a solid stretch of about 4 miles of U.S. 17 between Hardeeville and the Savannah River that, you know, the scenes just like you're seeing right now on the screen. I mean, it just wasn't one little localized spot. It was just, you know, we had a great spot to pull off and actually, you know, document this.
You know, Chris, we've spent the last couple of shows here on the Carolina Weather Group talking about flooding, especially along the coast. You're out there, you're taking pictures, you're on the Weather Channel, you're making observations, but we also saw you tweeting to the Weather Service. So what role can you explain to the audience that you're playing out there in addition to just photographer?
Right, right. And you bring up a great point. You know, it's not just about chasing the storm and shooting cool video and, you know, trying to see, you know, quote unquote, what the most extreme weather you can find is. You know, that is all part of it. Sure, let's be honest. That's all part of it. But goal in one is to get people information that could potentially save someone's life, or give them the information that they can save their own life. And, you know, that's bar none the most important thing. The little three-tweet thread I sent to Charleston, the first place we pulled up to with the tree across the road, I dropped a pin and started driving. And I had the tweet half done. We pulled up at the flooding. I finished the first tweet, shot video for the second one. And by the time we got down the street to the car in the ditch, I'm like, well, I'll just send it all right now. So it was kind of like a smorgasbord over about 15 minutes trying to put a little tweet thread together. But the rainfall down there, I'm telling you, all the ditches, the yards are full. I mean, I've never seen anything like that fast in person. That goes back to 2015 in Columbia. That little localized rainfall area for about an hour, man, that was some intense rain. You know, I think the WPC put a weather mesoscale discussion out for, 3 to 4 inches? I can't remember. I briefly looked at it because I was trying to drive and, you know, be safe driving, and didn't really get a chance to look at it too much.
Yeah, you can always tell a tropical rain versus just your standard deluge from like a storm event, right? I mean, when you have a tropical feed into that, it's almost like when you see it hit the windshield, you can tell the difference in that rain versus just normal rain on a rainy day or a storm.